to force automakers to speed up development of a new generation of airbags. They were joined by relatives of people who were killed by airbags. They say the new systems are needed now to prevent further deaths. Big three automakers say they already test airbags beyond government standards and are working to improve them. They say new government regulations would only slow down that process.
Joining me now is Gary Whitman, and we're live outside our studios. He is a restraint system and occupant protection engineer with ARCA Incorporated. Basically, you're an expert on airbags, right, Gary?
Right, in occupant crash protection.
Okay. Now, tell us, what could be the problem with the driver airbag?
Well, the key is to keep your body out of the envelope as it deploys. You want to load the airbag after it's deployed. You don't want to be in its path as it comes out. And that's true for the drivers and the passengers, but with the drivers, you're forced to be up close enough to control your vehicle.
Right, so what do they need to do to adjust the airbag deployment so that it doesn't injure you but protects you the way it's supposed to?
Well, in the design, you can design an airbag so that it behaves differently for the belted occupant versus the unbelted. And a belted occupant rarely needs an airbag if they're seat belted. So you could delay the airbag in coming out unless the crash is very severe, and you can make it much less aggressive, having it come out with less velocity and less pressure.
What about with the passenger side?
Well, with the passenger side, there's no reason for an occupant to be up close to the airbag.
So
many
I should be back.
You should be back. And if you would, if you can slide forward, you can see how ridiculously close you can get.
Right, and that,
there's
that
no
dangerous.
Need. There's no need for that for a right front passenger. So just keep your seat back and be belted.
And how should they test airbags? Because I know a lot of groups right now are saying you need to test them in a different manner than we test right now.
Well, that's true. When airbag regulations came out, they were trying to protect the unbelted occupant. And as a spot check, they test with a 50th percentile male dummy. Well, now most people are wearing their belts. They need to make sure that they're keeping the small woman safe and the large male safe. Children typically should be in the rear if they can be in a lap shoulder belt.
So they need to test all kinds of dummies.
All kinds of dummies, belted and unbelted.
Great. Gary, thank you.
You're welcome.
Much more debate on this issue. Arthur?
Okay, Tracy, thank you.